In this video, I'm going to take you through my top 5 tips for how to be an amazing presenter in Teams. Everything from getting control of your settings through to the most commonly asked question of how you present multiple things at a time. Make sure you stick around to the end for that one. Tip number 1, as a presenter, you want to have control over who else can present in your meeting and how people are going to be joining your meeting. Make sure as you set up the meeting, click here on this meeting options button. That will bring up in your default browser all of these options that you can choose from. Once you're happy with all of that, you can save and you are in control before you even begin. Once you're in the meeting, if you need to change any of those options, just go here into the More Actions menu, Meeting Options menu, and you'll find you've got everything there. So if you need to make someone a presenter who wasn't, you are able to change your mind once you're in the meeting. Tip number 2, as a presenter, you really want to be able to keep control of any questions that are coming through. Make sure you encourage your participants to use the virtual hand raise feature, which is here. As a presenter, what you want is to have this participant panel open on the side. Let's look at what happens when people start to raise their hands in the meeting. So first off, I can see that Molly's got her hand raised, and now we can see that Dan has also raised his hand, but you'll notice I've got little numbers next to them. This is a relatively new feature. As a presenter now, I know the order in which people put their hands up, and it makes for a much happier experience for everyone. Tip number 3, if all you need to share is a PowerPoint, this is going to make it absolutely easy for you. Save your PowerPoint in OneDrive. Absolutely critical, otherwise you won't get this option. When you're ready to go, you've got that open and this wonderful little button here, Present in Teams, boom, single click. And that's going to go through, confirm that I'm going to do that on purpose. It takes a minute or so to come up, and now we have PowerPoint live in Teams. The beauty of this is that I can navigate through and see my notes. The participants will just see my full PowerPoint. I've got an option here which can prevent the participants from skipping through the deck themselves, or I can leave it as it is and allow them to do that. And then check this one out, stand out. Here I am in front of my PowerPoint deck. Obviously, you need to design your slides in a way that is going to allow space for you to be present. And if you want to switch that off again, you can go straight back to there. The other thing here, I'm not sure how many tips I'm giving you all at once here, but go into your camera here and click Spotlight. And that's the other way to make your video more prominent for everyone else in the meeting when you're the presenter. All right, I reckon that was a 3-for-1 tip for number 3 there. Let's move on to tip 4, which is how to share something with audio. Have you ever tried to share a video, or have you ever seen anyone share a video and they can't get the sound to work? Here's how you do that properly. I'm going to go here into the share content tray, and I could choose to share a whole screen, or I can choose an individual window. I'm going to choose to share a whole screen here. But this is the critical thing if you want to share your sound, include computer sound, toggle that one on, and then when you share your screen, you will get that experience of the sound coming through in the meeting. Tip number 5, and this is the question that comes up the most often of all, what if I need to present a PowerPoint and a demo? In that case, I don't use the Present in Teams option. I actually get one screen with everything ready for it and present that whole screen. So before I go into that share tray, what I'm going to do is line myself up first. So first thing I do is go in and start my slideshow and have my slideshow coming up on the screen. So I've picked one monitor here and I've got that on the screen. Then I've also got my demo environment ready to go here on the same screen. Now, once I've done this once, I can now hold down my Alt key and press Tab and just Alt Tab back and forth between the two. But I've got that one screen where I'm completely in control of those things. So from there, all I need to do is I go in here, I'm going to share content, and now I'm going to choose the screen that has all of that on it. So there we go. I'm choosing that screen now. If you've got a second screen, you can actually drag your Teams meeting onto that second screen. If you're working with two monitors here, of course, this is now occupying one of those monitors completely. So then you want to choose what you've got on your second monitor. That can either be the Teams meeting itself, if you need to see those participants and hand raises and things we were looking at before, or it could be your PowerPoint deck with the presenter notes in the background. I tend to, with two monitors, have the Teams meeting on my second monitor so I can see what's going on, but I tend to work without notes in PowerPoint. If you need those notes in PowerPoint and you don't have a third screen, then grab your phone, your mobile device or whatever, join the meeting from Teams on your mobile device so that you can keep track of the hand raises in the meetings as your third screen. And so now as I work through my presentation, I can click ahead and talk about the wonderful new release features. And now I'm going to switch across to a demo of that. I just use Alt Tab and switch across into my demo environment and do all of that. Isn't that a wonderful demo? Thank you very much. And now I can go back to my PowerPoint to finish off. If you'd like to learn more about how to use the PowerPoint presenter mode in Teams, I've got another video here that takes you through that in depth, including being able to use annotations on the screen. Very, very cool. If you're after some more general tips, I've got you covered here as well. Top 5 tips for beginners, including some things that people don't know even when they've been using it for a while.